Second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me two turtle doves and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me two calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me on the sixth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me six geese a-laying, five gold rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love sent to me seven swans a-swimming, six geese a-laying, five gold rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me eight maids a-milking, seven swans a-swimming, six geese a-laying, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me nine drummers drumming, eight maids a milking, seven swans a swimming, six geese a laying, five gold rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the tenth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me ten pipers piping, nine drummers drumming, eight maids a milking, seven swans a swimming, six geese a laying, five gold rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me ladies dancing, ten pipers piping, nine drummers drumming, eight maids a-milking, seven swans a-swimming, six geese a-laying, five gold rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me 12 lords a-leaping, 11 ladies dancing, 10 pipers piping, 9 drummers drumming, 8 maids a-milking, 7 swans a-swimming, 6 geese a-laying, 5 gold rings, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. So during the 12 days of Christmas, my true love sent to me 12 lords a-leaping, 22 ladies dancing, 30 pipers piping, 36 drummers drumming, 40 maids a-milking, 42 swans a-swimming, 42 geese a-laying, 40 gold rings, 36 calling birds, 30 French hens, 22 turtle doves, and 12 partridges in a pear tree.
many years ago, before there were any automobiles and before we had electricity or even gas lighting, and when people used horses if they wanted to go out for a ride, and oil lamps and candles if needed a light, there lived in a small country town. Yes, a butcher, a baker, and a candlestick maker. With just over a week to go before Christmas, the townspeople were busy indeed. And none more so than the candlemaker and his young son, Tom. For in those days, quite small boys were expected to behave like grown men. Saturday at 4 o'clock, the candlemaker had been making the journey from his shop to the church across the square. Because God had been so good to him and blessed his home and his work, he showed his gratitude by giving his finest candles to shine upon the altar as an offering to God.
So shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Whenever I read these words of Jesus, I think of one of our own people, our friend the candlemaker. Like a good steward, shows his love for God by giving his most beautiful candles to light the cross upon our altar. I pray that all of us will always give in this same spirit, to show our love for the Father, who blessed us with a Christ child.
The family was up early next morning, for a busy week lay ahead. The candlemaker had to deliver quantities of Christmas candles of all shapes and sizes to the outlying farms and villages.
Hurry up, son.
Coming, Father.
Now. I'm not going away forever. I'll be back on Christmas Eve, in time for service. Look after your mother, son. And there are plenty of candles to be made.
Don't worry, Father.
Don't forget, this week, I'm leaving you to make the second altar candle. I have made only one. And remember, both must be taken over to church by 4 o'clock Saturday.
Yes, Father.
Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
Bye, Father.
With his father away and his mother extra busy getting ready for Christmas, young Tom was in charge of the workshop, with the task of turning out many candles a day. And then there was the altar candle for the Christmas Eve service on Saturday. Christmas Eve long ago, the church was made beautiful by the loving work of loving hands, just as churches are today. Then, as now, there was a manger where boys and girls would bring the white Christmas offering for the children's home.
Your father will be home soon. Tommy, you forgot. Run over quickly now. And be careful you don't drop them.
I'm sorry I was late for the candles, Pastor.
Never mind. You did do it. And just in time, too. Look who's coming.
Well, son, did you make the church candle?
Yes, Father.
Member of the family had his own sad thoughts that night.
To think that a son of mine should make such a candle, a worthless candle that won't shine, and after all these years.
Young Tom knew what his parents were thinking, that he had failed them, and that he had failed God.
Thank you.
So it was many years ago that the candlemaker's son learned the meaning of Christian stewardship, just as we must learn it today.